It's always a pleasure to talk to these two blokes. Welcome them back, will you? Peter Weir and Mel Gibson. Here they are. Well, here we are again, fellas, about to kick off something else. Now, we talked to you about this film a couple of months ago, when you first got back. It's now been previewed in America, they tell me. Is that right?
Yeah, I took it over about 8 weeks ago, 7 weeks ago, for the studio. It's an MGM film. And fairly tense sort of screening, naturally enough, and it went very well.
What do you mean when you say tense screening?
Well, I think any screening for the investor after you spend all the dough is a tense
time. Oh, you mean they put up the money, you shot this film, and this is the first time they've seen the
That's
end result?
Right, yeah.
Oh, that
and
is
was,
nervous. Yes. Yeah.
And it was on the MGM lot. Yeah. And you just can't help but be aware of the history of MGM Pictures. And so there in the vast sort of MGM auditorium with about six executives sitting there, you know, in a 2,000-seat theatre, you really start to sweat. And as the lion comes up and so on, you wonder whether you're going to sort of live up to the tradition of very fine films they've made.
Or they were going to say, deport Weir.
Yeah.
Yes, out. Put him out of here, out forever, yes. What was the reaction? Good?
It was very good, yeah. Yeah. Comparing with, you know, people who've gone through studios in very difficult times.
Yeah. Very difficult time making this film, though. What was it? There was...
it wasn't too bad. All right, shall I tell him the truth?
Yes. There were threats, I heard.
Threats?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I was offered several life assurance policies on the phone and asked if I was brave and things like that, at which point I said no and hung up. But,
did they know about your Mad Max reputation at that time? Did they know that that was you?
The Filipinos?
Yeah.
I'm not sure if...
Oh, yeah, they did the first one.
Didn't they?
Yeah. But that was not connected to the death.
Oh, I was just going to say, you know, sometimes that might have a rub off, you know.
Nah, nothing at all.
No, it was some sort of Muslim group.
No. Extremist. And it wasn't serious.
Oh,
right. Yeah.
It really wasn't.
Tell me.
Well, I heard that you left early because you did think it was serious. Is that not true?
You know, no, it's true. Yeah.
What's the point of cracking it over celluloid?
That's right, too. Yeah. If it's your life or the film, I'll take the film or something. It's like those guys that always say, the show must go on, you know. And you're coughing and sputtering in the wings. You say, why? I'm dying, you know.
Well, I spent 6 or 7 weeks sleeping in the bathtub. And
Sleeping or slipping?
No, sleeping.
Sleeping.
Oh, no soap.
And what's this about Elvis Presley's plane? Is this in the film?
Yeah, one of the problems that happened when we did have to leave because of the these threats was that we lost Elvis's plane. His plane has ended up in Manila.
Is that right?
And we needed a 707. Aircraft. Yeah. So we actually end up with the Prime Minister's plane, I must say. We shot in Sydney in the end, in that airport scene.
Is that right?
Yeah, so we changed it. It was very kind, thank you.
Get the seat that gave him the bag back. It might. Let's take a look at this. You know, this is another character that Mel Gibson plays. It's not like you are in real life, but you are. All these roles you always get seem to be these really cocky guys, you know?
Oh, this one. Well, he's particularly abrasive, I suppose. A good deal older, which is, a maturity gap. Try and jump that. Yeah. This man helped me, he's older.
Yes, he would understand you more than he would. So there's a scene we've got here with you and another bloke in a pub or a low dive or something. You
That's
go to
right.
start a dance. Who's the other fellow?
His name is Michael Murphy, and he's a very funny guy.
Is he American or Australian?
He's an American guy.
An American actor?
Yeah.
And what is the purpose? What are you doing in this scene that we're going to show in this club?
Well, we're actually celebrating his transfer from Jakarta to Saigon, which is where all the real stories are, in quotes. Yeah. That was where it was all happening then, the hots, 1965, Saigon.
They're kind of competitors, these two.
And a little military intervention here.
A little bit.
A little bit. Have a look. Here's a scene.
Stop, Dan. Out!
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Take it easy.
Out!
We're on the way.
Yeah.
We're just leaving. Good night, everybody. We had a lot of laughs. Adios.
Best bouncer in the business.
All right, so... we have to move on here, and I want to wish you luck. I understand the film doesn't open for another month or so, is that right?
Right, yeah.
Yeah.
17th of December.
Oh, there it is. World premiere, Adelaide, December the 9th, and other states, December the 17th. I cross my fingers for you, Peter, because you know what a big fan I am of yours and Mel as well. This is just one last question. There are rumors around, we hear reports, that there are offers for you to do motion pictures in the United States, amongst which are Raiders of the Lost Ark 2. Is that true?
Well, it's there's a lot of scripts falling from the sky at the moment. It's one of those times. I mean, I'm fortunate.
Yeah, sure.
I'm glad that that's happening. At the same time, I have to be wise about choices, you know, very selective and things. And
have you made any yet?
No, I haven't.
Well,
I'm
hang in there. As long as they keep offering, kid, you got nothing to worry about. You know what I mean? Peter, thanks a lot for coming. Nice to see you. And all the best of luck. Now, you too. Okay.
Ta-da! We'll be back. We got the wheel, I think. And Virgil. And more stuff. Whatever.